Hello everyone, today we'll discuss about properties of determinants. In previous section, we have learned how to expand the determinants. In this section, we'll discuss some properties of determinants, which simplifies its evaluation by obtaining maximum number of zeros in a row or in a column. These properties are true for determinants of any order. We'll discuss here the determinants of order 3 only. Let us start property 1. So what is property 1? The value of the determinant remains unchanged if its rows and columns are interchanged. Taking one determinant delta 1. So if delta 1 is equal to A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. If we interchange the rows and columns, we get here delta 2. Delta 2 is the determinant of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So here delta 2 is called transpose of the determinant delta 1. So these two determinants having the value same. Let us take an example, we'll prove this property 1. Let's verify property 1 by taking example. So this is an example. Delta is equal to determinant of 2 minus 3, 5, 6, 0, 4, 1, 5, minus 7. Expanding the determinant along first row. So the determinant is equal to expanding the determinant along first row. That means 2, we'll take here the values, corresponding elements are 2, minus 3, 5. And here we get the determinant is equal to 2 into determinant of 0, 4, 5, minus 7, minus 3. We get here the into 6, determinant of 6, 4, 1, minus 7, plus 5 into determinant of 6, 0, 1, 5. Now we get here 2 whole into 0 minus 20 plus 3 whole into minus 42 minus 4 plus 5 whole into 30 minus 0. So now we get here minus 20 into 2, minus 40, minus 3 into 42 plus 4, 46, plus 5 into 30. So you get here minus 40, minus 3 into 46, 18, 3 into 4, 12, 138, plus 150. So that is equal to 150 minus 8, 7, 178. So that is equal to 8 minus 28. We get here the value of the determinant is minus 28. Now, by interchanging the rows and columns, we get the transpose of the determinants. That is, delta 1 is 2, 6, 1, minus 3, 0, 5, 5, 4, minus 7. This determinant is equal to expanding along the rows. Row 1, we get 2 into 0, 5, 4, minus 7, minus 6 into minus 3, 5, 5, minus 7, plus 1 into minus 3, 0, 5, 4. Now we get here 2 into 0, minus 20, minus 6 into plus 21 minus 25 plus minus plus 1 into minus 12 minus 0. So now you get minus 40 minus 6 into 21 minus 25 minus 4 plus, sorry, this is minus minus 12. Now we get here minus 40 plus 24 minus 12 is equal to minus 28. Now we get the same values for two determinants, delta and delta 1. So we satisfy the property 1. Let us discuss about property 2. Property 2 is, if any two rows or two columns of determinant are interchanged, then sign of the determinant changes. We can denote the changes, the interchange of rows by Ri to Rj. Means we can interchange row 1 with row 2, we can interchange row 1 with row 3, row 2 with row 3. And we can denote the interchange of columns by Ci to Cj, double arrow mark here. C1 to C2, C1 to C3, and we can interchange C2 to C3 also. If we can interchange the two rows and two columns, then the value of two determinants are same, but the signs are different to each other. If first determinant having the sign, positive sign, then if interchanging the rows, we get the sign of the next determinant will be minus sign. So let us start, let us verify the result by taking one example. Let's verify property 2. Taking the same determinant, the determinant is 2 minus 3, 5, 6, 0, 4, 1, 5, minus 7. We have already found this determinant value is minus 28. Now we interchange two rows and we get the determinant is, we interchange row 1 with row 2. So the determinant is 6, row 1 is this, row 2. So 6, 0, 4, 2, minus 3, 5, 1, 5, minus 7. Now we get the value of determinant here. 6 into determinant of minus 3, 5, 5, minus 7. Minus 0 into 2, 5, 1, minus 7. Plus 4 into 2, minus 3, 1, 5. So this is equal to 6 into 21 minus 25 minus 0 plus 4 into 2 into 5, that is 10, 10 plus 3. So this is equal to 21 minus 24 minus 4. So 6 into 4 minus 24 plus 4 into 10 into 10 plus 3, 13. 13. So you get here 13 into 4. So you get here minus 24, 13 into 4. Ma 52 minus 24 is equal to 28. Now see this value, delta is equal to minus delta 1. So we verified the property 2 is verified here. Let us start property 3. Property 3 is, if any two row or columns of a determinant are identical, means all the corresponding elements are same, then the value of the determinant is 0. So what is the proof? If we interchange the identical rows, if we interchange the identical rows or columns, by property 2 we get the negative value of the first determinant. So here the determinant will not change, means delta doesn't change here. So by property 2, delta is equal to minus delta. So from this, 2 delta is equal to 0. That means delta equal to 0. For example, we will take here one determinant which having the same two rows, means 3, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3. See this example, row 1 and row 3 are same. So here, okay, and column 1, column 3 are also same. So we will find the determinant value of this determinant. This is 3 into 2, 2, 2, 3 minus 2 into 2, 2, 3, 3 plus 3 into 2, 2, 3, 2. So that is equal to 3 whole into 6 minus 4 minus 2 whole into 6 minus 6 plus 3 whole into 4 minus 6. We get here 6 minus 4 is 2, 2 into 3 is 6, minus 6 minus 6 is 0, plus 4 minus 6 is minus 2 into 3 is minus 6. So 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Now property 3 is verified by taking this example. Let us start property 4. If each element of a row or column of a determinant is multiplied by a constant k, if we multiply each row and each column by a constant k, then its value gets multiplied by k. For example, if we take the delta is equal to a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, b3, c3. So here we multiplied by a constant k in each elements of the first row. So we get here delta 1 equal to k a1. We multiplied a1 with k, k b1, k c2. Next, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. Now we get here, that is equal to k a1, expanding by, along row 1. We get here k1 into b2, c2, b3, c3 minus k b1 into determinant of a2, c2, a3, c3 plus k c, kc, this is 1, kc1 into determinant of a2, b2, a3, b3. So that is equal to, which is equal to k1, a1 into b2, c3 minus b3, c2 minus k b1 into a2 c3 minus a3 c2 plus kc1 into a2 b3 minus b2 a3. So here we get k whole into, taking common k, we get here a1 whole into b2 c3 minus b3 c2 minus b1 whole into a2 c3 minus a3 c2 plus c1 whole into a2 b3 minus a3 b2. Now here we get k into, this is the determinant value of delta, c a1 whole into b2 c3 minus c2 b3. B C2 B3 minus taking this minus B1 whole into A2 C3 minus A3 C2 plus C1 whole into A2 B3 minus A3 B2. So this is K into delta. So here we get multiplied, delta is multiplied by K. Now it is satisfied the property 4. Let us start property 5. Property 5 is if some or all elements of a row or column of determinant are expressed as sum of two or more terms. We can express sum of two or more terms here, sum of two terms. Row 1, each element of row 1, sum of two terms means A1 plus lambda 1. So then the determinant can be expressed as sum of two or more determinants. So for example, A1 plus lambda 1, A2 plus lambda 2 plus A3 A3 plus lambda 3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3 is equal to sum of these two determinants. We will verify by taking this example. So, we'll take here the left hand side of the determinant, that is LHS is equal to A1 plus lambda 1, A2 plus lambda 2, A3 plus lambda 3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So that is equal to A1 plus lambda 1 whole into determinant of B2, B3, C2, C3 minus A2 plus lambda 2 into B1, B3, C1, C3 plus A3 plus lambda 3 whole into determinant of B1, B2 into C1, C2. Rearranging the terms, we get here A1 whole into B2, C3 minus B3, C2 plus lambda 1 whole into B2, C3 minus B3, C2 minus A2 whole into B1, C3 minus B3, C1 minus lambda 2 whole into B1, C3 minus B3, C1 plus A3 whole into B1, C2 minus B2, C1 plus lambda 3 whole into B1, C2 minus B2, C1. So here we get A1 whole into this, taking these three terms, taking this term, this term, this term, we get here the determinant of first matrix A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So this is the determinant of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Plus taking second term, fourth term, sixth term, we get the determinant of lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So here we get the right hand side of the determinant. So we'll prove this proof, property proof of property 5 is verified. Let's take one example. Prove that determinant of A, B, C, A plus 2X, B plus 2Y, C plus 2Z, X, Y, Z is equal to 0. So, we'll take here the left hand side of the equation. So, now we get here A, determinant of A, B, C, A plus 2X, B plus 2Y, C plus 2Z, X, Y, Z. Applying property 5, we get here A, B, C, A, B, C, X, y, z plus a, b, c, 2x, 2y, 2z, x, y, z. Now here, these two rows are same. So this value of the determinant is equal to 0 plus taking common 2, applying property 4, we get here determinant A, B, C, 2 into determinant A, B, C, X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z. Here also row 2 and row 3 are same. So, the determinant value is 0. So, 0 plus 2 into 0, that is equal to 0. That is equal to right hand side. So, we will prove this question is proved by taking three properties. Properties 5, 2, 3 and 4. Let us start property 6. Property 6 is a determinant remains unchanged by adding k times the elements of any row or any column to the corresponding elements of any other row or any other column, where k is any given number. So here we will take the determinant a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. And when we multiply k with second column and adding this with column 1, then it becomes a1 plus kb1, a2 plus kb2, a3 plus kb3, b1, b2, b3 and c1, c2, c3. Column 2 and column 3 are same, but column 1 has changed. So this determinant becomes first determinant a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3 plus this. When applying the property, we get here kb1, kb2, kb3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. Now, applying the properties or common, taking the common constant k outside, so we get these two determinant, this determinant plus k into this determinant. So see here, b1, b2, b3, column 1 and column 2 are same. So value of this determinant is 0. So we get here the first determinant, that is a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. So, here the property 6 is verified. These are the properties of determinants. We will solve some problems in next section by using these properties. Thank you.